Hey guys, my name is Brian. This is Beard Guy Bri. In this channel, I take you along my beard growing journey, throw you some tips and tricks and things that I'm learning here along the way. If you haven't already, please hit subscribe down there and make sure you get the little bell icon so you get notified when I put out new videos. But let's get right into this one. So if you've been doing any kind of beard video searching on YouTube or anywhere, I'm sure you've seen lots of videos of guys trying minoxidil to grow their beard. Now, what is minoxidil? Minoxidil is basically the active ingredient in Rogaine. I'm sure you've all heard of Rogaine. It's been around for about 35 years or so. So minoxidil is used to help guys who are suffering from male pattern baldness, which is a genetic thing. So if you haven't noticed any hair thinning or hair loss by 30, 35, you're probably good. You're probably not going to experience any. I'm not so lucky in that I've been having some hair thinning over the past 10 years or so. So I've been, experimenting with this off and on over the past, 7-8 years and had some decent luck with it. It seems to be working all right. So is minoxidil safe? Yes. It's been on the market since the 80s. It went over the counter, I think, in 96, and really it's been used around the world by millions of guys every day. So a small percentage of guys do experience some sort of like a higher blood pressure or heart palpitations while on it. If this happens to you, obviously you should probably discontinue using it, speak with your doctor. It does come in two formulas or two strengths. You have 2% and 5%. So talk to your doctor. Maybe you need to go with the 2% instead of the 5%. The only other thing I've heard of really is some guys getting a kind of a dry, itchy, or red scalp when they use it. So if you're doing it on your face, you might also get that. So this is apparently more common in the liquid formula because of the alcohol or propylene glycol that they use in the product can cause skin irritation. So if you experience that, maybe switch to the foam or just start off the foam right away. So how does minoxidil work? So hair grows in cycles, and minoxidil stimulates hairs that are in the dormant phase to go to the growth phase. The growth phase can last anywhere from 2 to 6 or possibly more years before it then transitions to another phase and starts to fall out. Most of your hair is in the growth stage at the moment. So with male pattern baldness, with minoxidil, you pretty much have to keep using it. If you stop using it, your hair will fall out or go back to where it was before you started using it. This doesn't seem to be the same thing with beards. So should you use minoxidil on your face? Personally, I've been lucky with my genetics, with my beard. It comes in pretty bushy, thick here. So I don't really have any patchy areas where I need to use it. There is one kind of little bald spot under my chin, but thankfully my beard just grew in pretty nice and it covered it up. I do suffer from the male pattern baldness gene though. So this is getting thinner up through the top and I'm gonna losing a bit up top here in the back. So the big thing with beards, I'm sure you know, is patience, really. It takes time. So I probably wouldn't use minoxidil if you're, still in your late teens or early 20s. I'd probably wait until I'm at least 25. Mine didn't always grow in this thick. It did take some time through my 20s, and now I'm in my mid-30s now. So not everybody's beard grows at the same speed. So patience is always the best answer. But, if you can't wait that long, give it a try. It's not going to hurt you. So it won't work overnight. As I mentioned, the hair grows in cycles, so the time that it takes for it to go from the dormant cycle to the growth cycle is at least 3 months. So you're probably not going to see any results in the first 3 to maybe 6 months. So wait at least 6 months before you determine whether or not you want to keep going. I'd probably wait a year. I did that with my hair and it worked pretty well. I've been off and on for a while. So the recommended dose is about 1 milliliter twice a day. But this was from the original clinical trials in the 80s. And since there's been a lot of people using it over the years, they have found that you can probably get away with just using once per day instead of twice. So minoxidil can stay in the hair follicles there for up to 18 or 20 hours. So you can probably get away with only doing it once per day rather than two. And if you do that, you're going to save yourself a good amount of money and double the life of the product. This stuff's not super cheap. So give it a try. Maybe start with once a day. And after 5-6 months, if you're not seeing anything, you can always double up the dosage. So one thing to keep in mind is the foam takes only about 10 to 15 minutes to absorb into your skin, whereas the liquid stuff takes anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes. So if you don't want to sit around there with like a greasy face for 30 minutes a day before you wash it, you might want to switch to the foam. It's easier, it's a little easier to use, goes on quicker, and it's honestly less greasy. I noticed when I was using it on my hair, the liquid did make my hair feel real gross. And if you use it at night, then you get it on your pillow and it's you know, it's not the best. Foam tends to work better for me. So that's all I got for you today. If you're wondering if this will work for you, I mean, give it a try. What's the worst that can happen? You might get a little itch or irritation, but this stuff works, works on your hair, wherever you use it. So if you've used Minoxidil in the past and had any success with it, throw a comment down below. If you found this video helpful or useful, please hit the like there as well. That helps me a lot. And if you haven't already, please subscribe and get the little bell notifier there so you get notified when I put up new videos. That's all I got for you today. This is Beard Guy Bri. Talk to you later.